Hello everyone, I'm coming to you today to just do a short intro to how to take out your hair weave if you have it glued in without breaking your hair or losing hair. As you can see, I already took mine out, but I'm just going to give you an intro and then I'll go ahead and show you how I did it. So basically, I had a hair weave. It was glued in onto my actual hair, and I use simple products to take the glue out. I know a lot of you, the main reason you don't like glue is that it takes your hair out, you say, when you take it out. But if you properly remove the tracks, you reduce the possibility that your hair comes out. Now, there is still a slight chance that your hair may break with glue, but if you take it out properly and you still notice that your hair is shedding, breaking, or whatnot, it's a probability that you may be allergic to the glue or the chemicals in the glue actually took your hair out, not the glue itself, as far as, you know, taking it out and feeling like, oh, I took this glue out and now my hair is coming out. So I'm going to tell you how to properly remove it, but first I'll go ahead and talk about the ingredients in hair glue and the effect they can possibly have on your hair. This is just a little bottle of beauty supply hair glue that I got, and basically the ingredients are only four ingredients: latex, water, ammonium hydroxide, and fragrance. Now, I have this book. This is a great book for those of you who are interested in knowing what your cosmetics have in them. It's a consumer's dictionary of cosmetic ingredients. You can find it at your local library, which is where I got mine at, or any bookstore or online. And this is the newest edition, and it's very good at telling you a breakdown of any cosmetic ingredient, both organic or non-organic. So I'm going to tell you what it says about these ingredients. Okay, so first, the first ingredient here, put my bookmark, my receipt back in. The first ingredient it has in it is latex or rubber latex. So in here it says rubber. Okay, it says rubber as well as rubber-based adhesives is a common cause of contact dermatitis. This gum is obtained from a rubber tree and is not allergenic. The offenders are the chemicals added to the natural rubber gum to make it a useful product, such as chemicals as accelerators, antioxidants, stabilizers, and vulcanizers, many of which can cause allergies. Two or most frequent, but certainly not the only sensitizers, is rubber. They are, big word, I don't know those words. Don't forget that the edge of eyelash curlers may also have rubber, as well as false eyelash. Okay, latex. I already told you about rubber. Now I'm going to tell you about latex. It says here, latex, a synthetic rubber, the milky, usually white juice or exudate of plants obtained by tapping, used in beauty masks for coating ability, and various gums, resins, fats, waxes, in an emulsion of water and synthetic rubber or plastic are now considered latex. Ingredients of latex compounds can be poisonous, depending on which plant produces or which plant products are used, can cause skin rash, in rare cases, cause fatal allergic reaction when surgeons wear latex gloves. So, for those of you who have a skin allergy to latex, then you wouldn't want to use hair glue. I'm going to go back to the ammonium hydroxide. Like I was saying, it's used in all types of things. It says hair straighteners, a detergent for removing stains, can be irritating to the eye, mucous membrane, and may cause hair breakage. So I'm wondering, for those of you who lose hair after you've used glue and you have taken the time to make sure you do what I'm about to tell you, or your own method of using the dissolver to go across the hair and let it sit and, take them out and make sure there's no tension. It just easily slides off your hair. If you're doing that and you don't feel any ripping or tearing or pulling while you're taking it out, it just comes out with ease, but you notice like, oh gosh, I have bald spots, hair breakage, whatever. It may be the actual ingredients in the glue that you're sensitive to. So, with that being said, Yeah, so the hair glue, for me, my hair doesn't break, it doesn't shed, it doesn't do anything, so I guess I'm not sensitive to the ingredients. So I'm going to do a quick video and show you how I take it out. I use three things, three things. Shampoo, number one. Two, any cheap conditioner, Suave, VO5, White Rain, doesn't matter. Anything that's cheap, any kind of cheap conditioner. And sometimes, if they come out easily, I just use those two things. But if it takes a while and it seems like it's still not coming out, because sometimes they get glued in, you know, pretty good and that glue doesn't come out, I get a can of oil sheen. Any brand, pink oil, Motions, any oil sheen, you know, the old school oil sheen in the can. You just spray that on the track and let it sit for a good 10-15 minutes, and that oil breaks down, this rubber oil breaks it down, and you can just slide it off. So I'm going to go ahead and show you. Hopefully you'll be able to see, because what I did is first I came and I put the conditioner on the weave, let it sit for a few minutes under my steamer. If you don't have a steamer, it's okay, you just let it sit. After it sit for about 5-10 minutes, I pulled and it wasn't coming off. So I washed it with shampoo and they started slipping out. And then I put more conditioner and they started slipping out. And I washed again, slipped out. So I did it in my kitchen sink. So I'm hoping that you'll be able to see it. The reason I do it in the sink and not the shower is that don't want all that hair going down the drain. And sometimes it's hard to clean it all out of the shower because it's so big, you know. But the kitchen sink, I just put the stopper in to clog it up so the hair won't go down the drain. And I just take all the weave out in the sink. And then when I go, I just pull all the weave out with my hand, throw it in the trash. And I can go ahead and take the stopper out and there's no hair going down.
Okay, so the first thing we want to do is go ahead and start to cut the excess hair. This is going to save us product and also save us time and effort. So just trim away, making sure not to trim your own hair, of course. Trim the braid hair also. And just continue this process all the way down. Once you've got that done, get your conditioner, any brand, Suave, VO5, and just proceed to put the conditioner on the track. This is going to ensure that we get a little slippage and make the track release from our hair without breaking off our hair. So add a little more conditioner and just rub it in real good. And we're going to let the conditioner sit on our hair for at least 10 to 15 minutes. You're also going to do this on the braid part. You're going to put conditioner on the braids and just rub it in. Massage it all the way through your hair. And as the tracks loosen up, it'll be a much easier process to take them out. Hey, look at those guns. Alright, so now if you have a hair steamer, you're going to sit under the hair steamer for a good 10 to 15 minutes. The moisture and water will also loosen up the tracks and the braids. If you don't have a hair steamer, it's okay. Just use the plastic cap or plastic grocery bag for 10 to 15 minutes. Now we go over to our sink and put the stopper in. This is going to make sure the hair doesn't go down the drain and cause any major plumbing problems. Now we're ready to wash our hair. You can use any conditioner, or actually any shampoo you want, any Suave brand or anything like that. I'm using Organics brand. Just rub it in and loosen up the glue. Rinse it out. And now we're going to go ahead and use our conditioner to further loosen up the tracks. At this point, some of the tracks may easily slide out. You just want to make sure there is no tension when you pull them out. Make sure that they just slide off of your hair. If there's any tension, keep rubbing conditioner and rinsing and repeating the conditioner, shampoo, and rinsing until they slide out. And hold down the other braids and tracks so that you don't pull on your hair. Okay. And if your hair is longer, thicker, then it may take conditioner. But just keep repeating the process until the hair easily slides out. All the hair is out. So now what we're going to do is add more conditioner and remove the excess glue. So just rub the conditioner in and then take a wide tooth comb and slowly start to pick the glue out. Don't pull from roots to end, but pick down from the root to end so that you can get the excess glue out without pulling your hair. Just pull from root to end slowly with time and patience. You'll reduce the amount of breakage. So here's the glue in the comb. And what you see is only glue. My hair is not in the glue. So just look at the glue and make sure that you don't see strands of hair in the glue, and you'll know that you're doing it the right way. Just keep doing that same thing in small sections all the way through your hair. So I'm just making sure it's all out of my hair. Oh, forgot a track. Okay, so just comb your hair. If your hair is longer, of course, this is going to take more time. And just comb through. And at this point, you should have no breakage, no. And I hope this helps you to safely remove your hair weave without any breakage. Let me know how it goes. Thanks for watching. Bye now.